My name is Anders Kut. I'm the chief architect of Estonian Information System. And today I'm going to talk about IT organization alignment. It is strange that in this time and age, we still need to talk about the topic because IT is so deeply ingrained into everyday lives of all of our organizations. But it doesn't really mean that we need that we understand and can get along with the IT folks. So the topic is still very much hot, so to speak. Let's start by talking about three different kinds of people that exist in every organization. Firstly, we have the business people, very broadly speaking. The business people are focused on getting things out the door and making money for the organization. Their primary goal, their primary objective is to build as good things as possible, as valuable things as possible, for as little money as possible, with as little time as possible. These are the people that come to you and say, I would love to go to the moon tomorrow, and by the way, here are 5 cents to do so. Then we have development people, usually situated in the IT organization, but not necessarily so. The IT people are fundamentally engineers. They love to build things. They are architects, they are designers. They would love to spend hours and hours and hours on end to build the perfect thing, to spend a lot of time designing it. Everybody, every architect I've met would dream about building a equivalent of Taj Mahal in their medium, be it the concrete or software or something else. They love to build things. Their focus is there. And finally, we have operations people. These people focus on keeping things available, keeping things running cheaply, smoothly, safely, and reliably. Their responsibility is mainly towards the customers. For them, it is absolutely the best if things do not change at all. Even better if things are switched off, because the best, the most stable, the most reliable thing is something that is just switched off and sitting there. And so the interests of these three people are fundamentally conflicting. And it is not because people are stupid. Simple fact is that to do their job properly, any of those three needs to display those qualifications, have those interests, have those desires, or they will simply be replaced. They need that to do their job properly. So the question becomes, how do we make sure that these three actually get along? And every organization needs to figure out two things. Firstly, it needs to figure out where the balance in that triangle is. Because to balance something, you need to find the center of gravity, and that is different for every organization. Let me assure you, a bank thinks about these things much, much differently than a startup. And startup is again much different from, let's say, a factory that builds doors. So every organization needs to find out what is their balance between operations, development, and business. And secondly, every organization needs to figure out a way how to actually enforce that balance, how to prevent from any of those three from acquiring dominance that is not beneficial for the entire organization. Let's say operations people start dominating in the organization. That means that all development effectively stalls as things are stabilized. Of course, this is a very simple model, and for example, in many organizations, that balance is found and maintained by merging development and operations into a concept called DevOps. But the fundamental truth still holds that any organization needs to build a way to actually maintain balance between these three conflicting forces. Another way to think about this IT alignment or IT business alignment is to think about the organization holistically. we can think of the organization as consisting of the following layers or components or aspects. And being an architect, I call those architectures. Firstly, we have the business architecture. This basically tells us that we are, let's say, we are a lawn mover factory and rather than drilling for oil. In government, the business architecture is all about, let's say, the constitution and the basic setup of the society. Secondly, we have the organizational architecture supporting execution of that strategy, the organizational processes, the organizational structure, but also organizational culture. Then we have the functional architecture that supports the organization in executing its goals. For example, the functional architecture might contain pieces like the customer registry or the accounting part or the manufacturing support functionality. And also that layer defines how those different parts are interconnected. Underneath the functional part, we have clearly something that actually implements, in terms of software, those functionalities. So that we might have a functional piece called a document registry, which is then implemented on the next technical architecture layer as a set of databases governed by an application server. So a technical layer is about technical software components talking to each other. And finally, we have a physical layer. In this world of cloud computing and ubiquitous computing, we often forget that the software still needs some hardware to run on and still needs network for those computers to be connected. And this is what the physical layer is all about. You have to have a setup where hardware runs on the software that supports the function, implements the functional pieces, that supports organization, that executes a strategy. And if you think of the organization consisting of those layers, interesting things start to emerge. For example, you notice that there needs to be some sort of an alignment between the layers. For example, let's assume that we have a single piece of functionality that is governed by two separate organizational units. It is very clear and obvious that conflicts of interests will definitely rise, with one organizational unit needing to develop the functionality in one way and the other one needing to build it to do something completely different. And the same applies to all of the layers. There also is a thing called change management that becomes very apparent in that alignment model. Any change in any layer actually needs to inflict a change in all of the layers. If we do something on the technical layer, just change components around, it will have implications on higher layers. Of course, if we switch from one database platform to another one, its implications to corporate strategy is going to be limited. But still some change is required. And if there is a change on the process layer or organization layer, this is inevitably going to have an impact on the technical architecture. And this is usually what gets forgotten, that it is easy, relatively, to change the organization structure, change the processes, but the software implementing those processes might not necessarily be so easy to change. So we have two ways of thinking about IT and business alignment. We can think of the triangle: development, operations, and business. And we can think of the business, organizational, functional, technical, and infrastructure layers of an organization.